Okay, let's start to revise the lesson one, the soil components. Okay, before your exams, we took about the soil. So, what is the meaning of the soil? Soil meaning what? It's a thin, non-compacted. On the non-compacted means loose. So the soil means what? Soil means thin, non-compacted, means loose. It's loose, superficial or upper layer, which covers the Earth's crust. So the soil means what? What is the meaning of the soil? Soil, it's a thin, non-compacted, upper layer, which covers the Earth's crust, which covers the Earth's crust. So before your exams, also we talk about the soil components. Okay, the soil components. The soil consists of what? The soil consists of many components, such as like pieces of rocks, like this, big stones or small stones. Okay, big stone or a small stone, they are pieces of rocks. Okay, and also consists of sand, because the rocks consists of sand. Okay, clay means mud, clay and mud, the meaning, it's the same meaning, clay or mud. And also there is some water and silt. Silt also means silt, the meaning of the silt means like clay or mud, like the clay or the mud. And also there is some air, and the upper layer is called humus. Humus. So the soil consists of pieces of rocks. Number one, pieces of rocks, water, silt, air, humus. Pieces of rocks, water, silt, air, humus. Water, silt, air, and humus. And silt, the meaning of the silt, like the clay or the mud. So if you take a piece of soil, it consists of pieces of rocks, water, silt, air, and humus. Okay? So the soil consists of humus, water, also sand, clay or mud, and silt and gravel. Gravel, junior 5 means it's a small stones, pieces of stones. Gravel means like a pieces of stones. Okay? Now, we will talk about the humus layer. The humus layer. What is the meaning of the humus? Humus means like these pictures. This. It's a decayed remains of animals or plants. It's a decayed remains of animals and plants. After the death of the animals and falling some pieces of plants like leaves or roots or stems, any pieces of plants. Okay, after the death and then buried after underlying the ground, under the ground, and by passing the time. These pieces of animals or remains of animals and plants decayed. So these pieces of animals and plants mixed with the soil components to produce a layer called humus. To produce a layer, this layer called humus. So the humus means it's a decayed remains of animals and plants. Decayed remains of animals and plants mixed with the soil components. Mixed with the soil components. Its color. You The color of this layer, like what its color is dark brown or black. Is dark brown or black. So the humus, it's a decayed remains of animals and plants mixed with the soil component. Its color is dark brown or black. How is the humus formed? How is formed? Like when the living organisms die, when the plants or animals die, their body decayed, forming humus. Okay. هل الهيومس add nutrients to the soil or no? I ask you these questions before your exams. The humus add nutrients to the soil. The humus add nutrients to the soil. They add some nutrients or food to the soil. They became the soil here became comfortable to the agriculture. So the humus add nutrients to the soil. So what is the meaning of the humus again? Humus means decayed remains of animals and plants. Mixed with the soil components, its color is dark brown or black. Its color is dark brown or black. So the color of the soil, the color of the soil is dark brown or black due to the presence of the humus layer. So the humus affects the color of the soil because its color is dark brown or black. Again, this page, from this page, I need the meaning of the soil. What is the meaning of the soil? It's thin, non-compacted upper layer. Thin, non-compacted upper layer covers the earth's crust. Covered the earth's crust. What is the components? What is the components of the soil? What are the components of the soil? The soil consists of water, silt, air, humus, pieces of rocks. Pieces of rocks. And then what is the meaning of the humus? The humus means what? Humus, it's a decayed remains of animals or plants. After the living organisms die, when the living organisms die, their bodies decay. So the decayed remains of animals and plants mixed with the soil components, its color is dark brown or black. So the color of the soil is black or dark brown due to the presence of the humus, because the humus layer, because the humus layer is dark brown or black. Okay? Now we will talk about the importance of the soil. The importance, so the color of the soil is dark brown due to the color of the humus, which is dark brown or black. Now we will talk about the importance of the soil. What is the importance of the soil? Soil, it's very important to all living organisms. Without the soil, there is no living organisms on the earth. So the soil is important for plants, important for animals, and also important to worms, and also important to the human. So the soil, it's very important to all living organisms. So the plants, the soil is important for the plants. Why? Because the plants take the water and minerals. If you plant any plant in the soil, so this plant takes the water and minerals from the soil to grow, to live and grow up. So the plants take the water and minerals from the soil to live and grow up like this. So if you plant any plant in the soil, this root, the root of the plant, take the water and minerals from the soil. Also, there is animals. There are some animals like cows. They eat the grass or eat these plants. So the soil is important for the animals. Number three, there are some animals like earthworms, like the worm, like spiders, like ants, any small animals, they make their home in the soil like this. This is the earthworm. This earthworm, they live in the soil. They make its home in the soil. Also, the human eats plant. All of you eat plants, eat vegetables, eat fruits, eat animals like cows or hen or rabbit. Eat the animals that also eat the plants. So the human eats plants and humans. So the soil is very important to plants, to animals, and human. Plants, animals, and human, because the plants take the water and minerals from the soil. Animals eat plants, human eat plants and animals. So the soil is very, very, very important component. Now we will talk about the soil erosion. Soil erosions. What is the meaning of erosions? Means damage. Erosion means damage. The soil erosion or the soil damage, the soil can be damaged by the breaking down of the rocks. If the rocks breaking down into small pieces, into sand or silt or pieces, small pieces of rocks like gravel, so the soil, it will be damaged. The erosion happens to the soil. So by several factors, by many factors, what are these factors that causes the soil erosion? Like number one, like running water, like the rains. When the rains falls, the water breaks down the rocks. The water breaks down the rocks into small pieces. So the heavy rains or running water like these heavy rains may cause soil erosion because they cause the breaking down of the rocks. Also the wind. The wind also breaking down the rocks then causes soil erosions. Wind means الرياح الشديدة. لو في هواء جامد جدا الهواء ده the air may cause breaking down to the rocks then causes soil erosions. And also the change in the temperature, the weather, if the weather is very, very, very hot or then it's very, very, very cold. So the change in the temperature, it may cause breaking down to the rocks by passing time. The change in the temperature breaking down the rocks. So it may cause the soil erosion. So again, number three here. The soil erosion. Soil erosions happen due to the breaking down of rocks. The soil damage. The soil can be damaged by the breaking down of rocks because the breaking down of rocks. By many factors or several factors. What are these factors? Like running water. Running water means the heavy rains, running water, and wind, and a change in the temperature. All of these factors may cause breaking down of the rocks, so it may cause soil erosion. Okay, again, from the beginning, let's recap. What is the meaning of the soil? Soil means thin, non-compacted upper layer. Thin, non-compacted upper layer that cover the earth's crust. The soil components, they are five components: humus, water, air, silt, pieces of rocks, and also pieces of rocks consist of sand, clay, minerals and gravel. So what is the meaning of the humus? All of you know the humus. It's a decayed remains of animals and plants. Decayed remains animals and plants covered the earth's crust, which covered the earth's crust. Its color is what? Is dark brown or black? Its color is dark brown or black. The humus add nutrients to the soil. The humus, it's very, very, very important layer in the soil because it adds nutrients to the soil. It adds nutrients that the plant need these nutrients to grow from the photosynthesis process. So the humus add nutrients to the soil. And the color of the soil, the color of the soil is dark brown or black due to the presence of the humus layer. Due to the presence of the humus layer. Okay, now we will talk. We talk about the importance of the soil. What is the importance of the soil? The soil, it's very important to plants, to animals. Some animals like worms, earthworms, or spiders, or ants, and also to the human. The soil, it's very important to the plants because the plants take the water and minerals from it to live and grow. Also important for the animal because the animals eat the grass or eat these plants. Also important to the human because the human eat plants and eat also animals that is previously fed on the plants. And also they important for earthworms or spiders or ants because they make their home inside the soil. They escape from enemies by hiding them in the soil. Okay, number three, we talk about the soil erosions or the soil damage. The soil erosions happen due to the breaking down of the rocks. Breaking down of the rocks. What causes breaking down to the rocks? Like running water, like wind, and a change in the temperature. Change in the temperature. Running water, wind, a change in the temperature, all of these factors may cause breaking down to the rocks. Okay? We stop to now. Next session, we will talk about, we finish the lesson. Okay? Any question during five? Any questions? Anyone need to ask me any questions?
No.
Okay. Thanks. Miss you so much. Okay, 25. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye. Oh. 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 Oh.